What if?
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 What if there was a place?
What if there was a place to give children and adults of all abilities?
All abilities.
The chance to
improve
my motor skills.
Make new friends.
Get some exercise.
And have fun.
And have fun.
And have fun.
And have fun.
And fun.
When you have awoken.
Hi, I'm Channing Proctor, the founder and president of the Play Today Foundation. Here in Charleston, South Carolina, such a facility is not a distant dream, but rather a delightful reality. We play adaptive sports like baseball, plastic ball, and soccer on our rubberized field. Our Healthy Play Wiffle Ball Leagues are open to players of every talent level, and our state-of-the-art adaptive playground offers therapy and fun for people of all ages through the lessons of informal play. Make today the day that you get involved and make a difference in your own life and the lives of others in your community. For a list of Play Today Foundation facilities near you, visit us online at www.playtodayfoundation.org. Get engaged, get healthy, and play today, because when you give the gift of fun, you can change a life forever.
You again start hoping with your arms wide open. Come on, dance with me. Oh, dance with me to the colors of the dusk. And all will be right. We'll be right. Dancing like water with the light. Oh, dance with me. Won't you dance with me into the colors of the dusk? Of the dusk, dance with me to the colors of the dusk.
Hi, my name is Karen Proctor, and there are tons of kids here who can't get up this playground. So we're going to build a new playground with lots of ramps, even maybe a zip line. So maybe they can get up.
Hi, my name is Dr. Patty Coker-Bolt, and I'm an assistant professor in the Division of Occupational Therapy at the Medical University of South Carolina. Wouldn't it be great to see an adaptive playground right here in Charleston, South Carolina, that children that are able-bodied and children that have special needs would both love to come out and play on together? Instead of having a segregated playground just for children with special needs and a playground that only is engaging for children that are able-bodied, we don't want that segregation. We want them playing together. We want them to learn about each other.
My name is Lisa Hobbs, and my son Joshua has Down syndrome, and he's played here, he's played baseball here since spring of 2005. And
Mommy, what would you like?
It's right over there underneath that napkin.
Look.
Right there.
What's his?
It's the Coca-Cola underneath them. Every week, Joshua looks so forward to coming and playing. You know, he gets his gear on, gets his baseball jersey on and his hat, and he's got to find his glove, and he really gets excited, and he has all of his trophies and his medals and everything that he has won, and he's so proud of himself. One of the things that my children really love after the baseball game is to go over to the playground and play on the playground. Our Saturday event, we have a baseball game and then we go to the playground.
We'd like to see kids of all different types of abilities get out here on these playgrounds and play together, because that's what it's all about. And this is the time to do it. We want children without special needs to come and look at this playground and go, wow, I want to be here. And we want children with special needs to not fear going out on that playground. We want them to engage with typical peers.
To see them play on this playground, it's a wonderful joy, but you also see some of them frustrated because they can't utilize it like they would like to, you know, like other children can.
We'd like to see a playground that would offer the ability for a child that's a wheelchair user, or a child that has poor endurance, or a child that has a visual impairment, or a child that has motor difficulties where they can't travel through the sand, or they can't travel over an uneven surface without tripping. We'd like to have a barrier-free environment so they would feel safe, because really there's no structure on here that they could play on at this time.
Joshua have occupational therapy and physical therapy since he was 3.5 weeks old, every single week of his life. And what a wonderful tool this would be for children with special needs for their therapies. Physical therapist could come here and utilize this playground to help these children build their skills and build their muscles.
I also think about our adults that have disabilities, that have children without disabilities. It would be really hard for a mother that was in a wheelchair to bring her children onto this playground and to really interact with them. So she'd have to kind of be on the outside looking in, which isn't what parents want to do. They want to be out there on the playgrounds with their children.
I think it would be a wonderful asset to West Ashley if we had a baseball field and a playground that facilitated children with special needs.
And that's what childhood's about, is being able to learn how to play with each other and learn those social skills and the confidence to move forward.
If you have never been to this place, you need to come, because you will leave here a different person.
Thousands of runs have been scored right here on our special baseball field for kids and adults. Hey, Don, you got some chips?
Hey.
But we're looking to do some things that make even more of an impact. Kids and adults with special needs learn the lessons of formal play right here on this field. But we want to do something else. Walk with me. When we built this complex 5 years ago, we knew there would be an opportunity to make an even bigger impact within the community. Come with me. So what we're getting ready to do next is we're actually going to build an adaptive playground. So as I walk you through our complex, I want you to think about what an adaptive playground might mean for the Charleston community here. It's going to mean that kids and adults with special needs have the opportunity not only for the formal lessons on the field we just saw, but also the chance to learn the informal lessons that come from an adaptive playground. One that has wheelchair access, one that has the ability to let kids that are blind or impaired in other ways to actually come out and play informally. So this is where we're going to put that playground, right over here. This is going to be a model for the rest of the country and the rest of the world, because one of the things that we've learned is there's so many lessons that come with play, both the formal lessons of adaptive sports and the informal lessons on the monkey bars. So this is a great playground now, but in the future it's going to be even better. We're going to have a rubberized surface here, we'll have the ramps, we'll have some platforms within the trees, and it's going to be a place that all kids and all adults of all abilities can come out here and really interact and have a positive influence in their life. Won't you join me? Join the movement, because when you give the gift of fun, you give the gift that keeps on giving.